artifacts that are all laying flat, that indicates to us that those are in the position that they were dropped. So they were dropped on that floor and hadn't been moved for 13,000 years.
13,000 years ago, most of Michigan was covered by glaciers up to a mile high. That has always led archaeologists to believe that the continent's earliest people, called Clovis, didn't settle here.
We thought previously that people moved into Michigan from the lower 48 after Clovis times.
But after archaeologist Thomas Talbot found some artifacts in St. Joseph County, that's in western Michigan, a whole new story began to tell itself.
I have walked these fields for Indian artifacts for years. Whenever there's bare ground, you know, when they plow it up and it rains, I'm out there looking to see what I can find.
And on a day back in 2008, he found the very tip point of a spear, an item that rewrites history as we know it.
The Clovis point turned up, and that's pretty much out of place for that line of thinking because it's about 13,000 years old.
Far older than everybody thought an item could exist here in Michigan.
That makes this a really significant site, especially for Michigan, but also for North America.
Thomas got in touch with some leads at U of M's archaeology department, and they started excavating the site.
Excavating a Paleo-Indian site like this, which is really old, is a lot of work because of the precision. So we really go super tiny, really slow, through the soil, painstakingly slow.
Eventually, they uncover the 10 by 10 meter excavation site called the Belson site. What they found are key artifacts that imply that people were here in Michigan way before we previously thought.
We've been finding broken spear points. We've been finding scrapers, gravers, all the things that you would need to survive out in the wilderness on your own.
It may have been a hunting group. It may have been a family. Either way, it potentially changes everything for Michigan's place in history.
Well, what this means for Michigan is that we have a history that's as long as everybody else's history, and that we might even have a unique process of proliferation of people early on in Michigan.
Derek Kevra, Fox 2 News.